in your way, so you can afford to bump.
You can afford to bump, you can even afford stress in units. Yeah.
Well, stress,
that's then again, the stress expertise.
And the expertise. Yeah. Not Bengar, she's still essentially re-rolling two dice.
But stress controlled can shut her down.
Really shut her down.
Arc dodging can also shut her down, because although they have two arcs, unless they're converging to cover areas, they can be arc dodged very easily.
Yeah.
I do agree with Yesenhal that people probably get annoyed with the big small ships because the moles always bump. However, there's a solution to that. Put on another pick.
Yeah, put it up, down, take it off.
Yeah.
Yes. We can play the game with no models, it does play the same.
It does play the same. The models just make it look nice.
Yeah. I mean, you've got the Decimator, it sticks over a large base, so...
Or the Ghost, yeah.
Yes, the Ghost, the Falcon, I mean, yeah. There's plenty.
But most of the large base ships do actually go over their base.
And even the T-70s breaks over one of the base, doesn't it? So... Yeah.
Speaking of models, isn't that a paint job on Nibble really good? I have to admit, yes. David is a fan of purple, and he does carry it quite well. I like the pinstriping and the hazard radiation markers.
Yeah.
I might get to fill that later. I do like it when I see painted ships. Do you paint your ships?
No.
Nor do I.
Part of the reason I like this game is because I don't have painted ships, and they already look great.
I was never interested in 4K. I like the story of 4K. Never liked playing the games, never liked painting the models.
I've played for years, but only with the worst painted models. I just got okay at painting when I stopped playing.
See, I really want...